Welcome back to my channel. My name is Princess Tacha and welcome. If you're new here, welcome. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please consider to subscribe to my channel because that will make me easier to get your energy for the next reading. And thank you so much for everyone that already subscribed to my channel. Please like, comment, and share this video. Alright everyone, today we're going to find out what assumptions do men make about you based on your looks. Alright, in front of you there are three pictures. You just have to think about the question and pick the first picture that comes into your mind. What assumptions do men make about you based on your looks? And I'll see you on your reading. Hello, my dear beautiful group number one. For my viewers who pick group number one, this is your reading. Welcome to my reading. My reading is timeless. You are meant to see it right now. My name is Princess Tacha. Thank you so much for everyone that already subscribed to my channel. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel because that will make me easier to get your energy for the next reading. And in return, you help my channel to grow. And please also click the bell button so you will not miss any future readings from me. Please like this video, comment, and share. And thank you for all of your support. All right, everyone. Today, we're going to find out what assumptions do men make about you based on your looks. All right. Now, please show me for my viewers who pick group number one, what assumptions do men make about you based on your looks? What assumptions do men make about you based on your looks? You have the Nine of Pentacles. So here we see with the Nine of Pentacles card, based on your looks, men assume that you are someone that is successful, you accomplished, okay? You feel satisfied with your life, okay? Maybe you have a lot of going on in your life right now, but you look very rich. You look very classy, okay? Men assume that you are someone that has this financial stability, or you invite a lot of prosperity and abundance in your life, okay? You dress very comfortable, like every clothes, when you wear it, it looks very elegant and classic. And also, I see it here, group number one, for my viewers who pick group number one. You look very chic, very stylish, okay? People always curious of what a brand that you use. Maybe your sweater, your pants, your suit, your shirt, your shoes, your makeup, what brands that you use. Because even to the point of your makeup, you look flawless, you know? It's probably just drugstore makeup. Don't get me wrong. I love drugstore makeup too, okay? But then it looks flawless. It looks beautiful on you, okay? So men assume that you wear branded stuff, that you look very chic, that you're elegant, you look very accomplished and successful, okay? Based on your looks. You look like that, okay? Now with the Hangman, a man assume that you are someone that is willing to sacrifice temporary happiness for permanent pleasure, okay? So based on your looks, men assume that you've been there, done that. You know, you've been through a lot, been through a lot of problems, been through a lot of mistakes, but that's not stopping you from reaching your destination. You're willing to wait, you know, wait in limbo. You're willing to wait your moment to shine. So based on your looks, you're such a very patient. You look a very hardworking person. You're willing to sacrifice temporary happiness for long-term pleasure. That's what I see it here, okay? My group number one. That's based on your looks, okay? You also look like someone that is waiting for your time to shine. So you're still in the process of climbing this ladder of success, climbing your momentum. And based on your looks, you look like someone that is waiting for your time to shine. But you have that very patient. You're very patient naturally in nature, okay? That's what I see here. And then also some of you, you look like a very sensual, earthly sensual. So you probably have very strong earth sign in your birth chart, Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. Doesn't have to be that way, but it's just for some of you, okay? This is general reading, take what resonates, but that's what I see here based on your looks. You look very sensual. You love neutral color like black, white, gray, brown, or that color really good on you, okay? You probably love also colorful clothes, but you're really good in earthly color. That's complement your looks really good, okay? You also have Eight of Swords. So based on your looks, men assume that you're someone that captured men's heart. You know, it's easy for you to trap them into your love, like, because you're so magnetic. So that's what Eight of Swords is like. You trap men, and based on your looks, you look like a heartbreaker. You look like someone that got a lot of attention from opposite gender or same-sex gender based on your preference of romantic interest. But based on your looks, you're someone that is hard to get, okay? That is hard to get. That people trying to trap you, but it's just hard to get you. People trying to make you their partner, but it's just so hard to tame you. You're like this piece of firecrackers. You probably have also a strong fire sign in your birth chart. You can be Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. Doesn't have to be that way. It's just for some of you. But it is possible that you are very passionate, have that fire inside of you, and it the man could see that, the man capture that from you, okay, based on your looks, okay? You look like someone that is dangerous, sexy, dangerous, that could easily trap a man into your love nest, that once they decided to love you, it's hard to forget you. You're unforgettable, okay, with Eight of Swords. You are unforgettable. So based on your looks, you look very unique. You are such a unique person. You probably have a unique jewelry or unique style or just unique clothing style, unique color that you pick for your style, or makeup or hair color, even red or brown, okay? Or black hair, I see it here. Blonde or brown, okay? You have dark hair or red hair or brown or even blonde or brunette. But then that hair looks really beautiful, and men truly realize that they trap into your look, okay? Based on your looks, men assume that you're someone that easily get attention from men, okay? That easily make other people falling in love with you, okay, my dear viewer, that big group number one. You also have this Five of Cups. So based on your look, you're someone that you've been through a lot again, okay? There is this eye of seriousness. There's this air of seriousness. You see life as the goal that you need to accomplish. But then through this all, you look very accomplished in the end. Because you never give up in your Five of Cups moment, okay? Based on your looks, you are someone that is very serious, that is very hardworking, that is very humble. You're such a humble person, okay? None of this card telling me that you are a cocky person. You are nothing but a very humble. You know, you are very kind and humble. And but then you have that pride of your hard work. So based on your look, men assume that you know your worth, okay? You know what you bring into the table, okay? That you have been through a lot. You've been through loss. You've been through disappointment. You've been through something that meant to break you, but it didn't break you. It make you stronger, okay? So men assume that you've been through a lot based on your eye look, based on your gazing, eye gazing, the way you look to men or the way you look to other people or the way you treat other people with respect. It shows to men that you've been through a lot. But then through that time, you learn that you need to also be kind to other people because it's just not feel good being in that position. And so once you are in this Nine of Pentacles position, Nine of Pentacles vibes, Nine of Pentacles life destiny with full of abundance and accomplishment and splendid things and prosperity, you look very graceful, okay? This all card, the Hangman, Eight of Swords, Five of Cups, coming after the Nine of Pentacles to show your history. You're someone that is graceful. So men assume that you're such a graceful person, okay? My dear group number one. All right, now what else? What assumptions do men make about you based on your looks, okay? You have gossip. Okay, so based on your looks, you look very influential. You look very flashy with branded stuff, okay? Some of you. But you look also very chic that people gonna talk about you. People talk about the way you dress. People talk about your accomplishment. People talk about your past event that happened and how that transformed you, how that you made a glow up, that your glow up actually invite people to talk about you. Hey, people still gonna talk, guys, okay? So don't be afraid of people talking about your accomplishment. People talk about your style. They actually silently inspired by you, okay? So you awaken consideration for the feelings of others. And then you look very trusted. So based on your looks, you look a very trustworthy person, okay? This gossip, honoring trust, okay? So men truly can put their trust on you. Maybe your job for some of you is a consultant, counselor, business consultant, or psychology, or you study about legal, to be a legal consultant or a lawyer, or psychology or medical, you know, to place a trust that you need to have that trust, okay? That people need to have trust on you, okay? So based on your looks, you look very, very trustworthy, okay? Men assume that you are someone that truly honor trust, that honor truth, okay? But then your appearance, your accomplishment invite gossip. So this is someone that truly easily to invite attention, either from same sex or opposite sex, or just from platonic relationship too. It is possible that either women talk about you, gossip about you, okay? So men assume that you're such a very popular girl, popular man. If you are a man, then men assume that you are a very popular person in general because people love talking about you, everything, okay? Your accomplishment, your prosperity, your abundance, your partner, your romantic relationship, okay? So that's based on your looks, okay? So men assume like that about you. Now, what else? What else that men assume about you based on your looks? You have monk nun, selfless devotion and single-minded dedication to spirit. So you maybe wear crystals, pendant, amethyst, crystal amethyst, rose quartz. You keep some crystal with you that means it. Or you, maybe if you are Christian and you have a cross, you have some, your religious that you, if you are connected to some or particular religion, then you wear some sort of like religious accessories. Okay, like cross, rosary, or amethyst, or rose quartz. Okay, or you have your manifestation book, you have the law of attraction book, you have your journal, you have your dream journal. You look like someone that is so spiritual, that is religious. If you don't have religion, then you look like someone that is so spiritual. So based on your looks, men assume that you are someone that is so devoted in your spirituality, that is so spiritual. Okay, now what else? Thief. You look very polished. You look very sexy. You look like someone, see, can steal the attention. Eight of Swords, okay? This is confirmation. You look like a sexy person that truly can capture and steal people's attention, okay? You truly have a lot of potentials inside of you that truly can steal people's attention. Maybe you have beautiful voice. Maybe you cook really good, okay? You can cook really good. You bake. You love baking. You love cooking for some of you, okay? I see that. And your food, when you serve that to people or to men in general, they truly love your cook, okay? You can truly steal someone's heart from their stomach, okay? From the food that you make for them, if they love it, if it's delicious, okay? But you also have this talent that you have your charm. You're so charming, okay, with the thief card, okay? This is a charming person. This is someone that is charming, someone that is so magnetic, and someone that truly can capture people's attention just based on their looks only. Okay, with your looks only, you already can capture people's attention to you. Okay, you truly steal the whole room attention. When you came into the room, people realize nothing. Then they realize nothing but you. They are being forced to admit that you have this strong fire energy too inside of you, but also earthly sensual beauty. Okay, so that's based on your looks. Okay. People and our men assume that you are someone that can easily get attention. There is attention seeker. You are someone that love attention. Okay. Hey, I also love attention, guys. It's normal. It's good. Okay. What else? Okay, my dear viewers, pick group number one. What assumptions, what else, what assumptions do men make about you based on your looks? You have the devil. Oh wow, didn't I tell you earlier I shuffled this card in front of you? Yeah, you're just this very mysterious, very sexy man feel tempted near you, okay? This is temptation. This is sexy person. Very sexy, very beautiful, very magnetic. You have a very strong sexual attractiveness about you, okay? Men attracted to you sexually too, attracted to your body, attracted to your looks, attracted to your charisma. You are a very charismatic person. You truly can steal attention with your words, with your looks, with your dress, with the way that you put your makeup on, with your aura, with your vibes, okay? Your vibes is a temptation, okay? Some of you has a very strong Capricorn, the devil, Capricorn. or earth sign in your birth chart, but I can truly see a Capricorn here. I can truly relate to this card, okay? Because I have Capricorn in my birth chart. But you guys, you too, you have this Capricorn, very strong, charismatic, sexy person, mysterious, but at the same time, you truly are passionate, and you are, you know, you're not afraid to show other people your sexual desire, your beauty, your skin, okay, with the way that you dress up. You look very gorgeous. This is the looks, if the looks could kill, this is the card that truly get other people attention very fast, okay? You just are very magnetic, very beautiful, okay? Based on your looks, you look very magnetic, look very sexy, look very beautiful, okay? Wow, boss energy here with the Nine of Pentacles, boss energy too, okay? Now with the Three of Wands, you look very elegant, okay? Based on your looks, men assume that you look very elegant, that you have your own style, that you love traveling, you love being on the beach, okay, with the ship here, but you also have very strong water sign, or you are very someone that is very sensitive. So based on your look, you probably is a Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpio, okay? You look very mysterious. You look very also adventurous, okay? Based on your looks, you look very adventurous. You love adventure and traveling. What else? King of Pentacles, yeah. You look very accomplished again, okay? You are such a hardworking person. You love showing other people the fruits of your hard work. So based on your look, you're someone that is so proud in your effort, proud in your journey, that through this journey, it shaped your character. And men assume that you're someone that has a lot of experiences in life. It's either about love, relationship, or financial. Or if you're still in school, men assume that you're someone that is so diligent, that is so hardworking, that you're willing to go extra mile to get extra score, to get a better score. You want to get a better job or get a good job later on after you finish school. But based on your looks, men assume that you are someone that truly has this vision of abundance, vision of successful, that you're such a successful person, okay? You're such a dedicated person. Based on your look, you look very smart, okay? Maybe you love dressing preppy style, or you just wear glasses. For some of you, literally wear glasses, or you just love reading book, okay? Love studying in general. You love also about finance, and you also look chic and elegant, okay, based on your look. And you are so spiritual, okay? You are so religious or spiritual. You're strong in your spirituality. You are such a devoted person to your spiritual journey, okay? Or your growth, you are devoted to your growth journey, okay? That's your reading for today, my dear group number one. If you're attracted to watch another pile, go ahead. There must be another message for you there. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed. And also, please click the bell button so you will not miss any future readings from me. You're welcome to watch my other pick a card video readings in my time in my playlist, because I have so many timeless pick a card videos reading that you will absolutely love it. Thank you so much, guys. Please comment, like, and share this video. And I'll see you on my next video. Thank you and bye-bye. Hi, my dear group number two, for my viewers who pick group number two, welcome to your reading. My reading is timeless. You are meant to see it right now. Before we begin, I would be very grateful if you're willing to subscribe to my channel. And also, don't forget to click the bell button so you will not miss any future readings from me. Please also comment below, like, and share these videos. I'm so thankful for everyone that always support my channel. All right, guys, so for my viewers who pick group number two, show me what assumption do men make about you based on your looks? What assumptions do men make about you based on... Okay. What assumption do men make about you based on your look? For my viewers who pick group number 2, what assumption do men make about you based on your look? What assumption do men make about you based on your look? All right. Group number 2. What assumptions do men make about you based on your look? You have the moon. Yeah. Based on your look, right off the bat, men assume that you're someone that is so mysterious, okay? You have that mystery aura about you. You're also someone that is sensitive. You have a very strong Cancer in your birth chart, and you're so delicate and soft, okay? You're probably a soft-spoken person, or you have a very soft heart. So based on your looks, men assume that you're someone that probably speaks softly, speak kindly, and you're mysterious, okay? And you have these looks of dreamy, okay? You probably like princess, prince, queen, kings, or romance novel, history novel. You really love something that is so dreamy. You love fairy tale, okay? So you really love magic and fairy tale or magical creatures like unicorn, wolf, or something else, okay? So based on your looks, you may assume that you're someone that is mysterious, have a very strong intuition, and also dreamy, okay? You have the Four of Pentacles. So based on your looks, men assume that you are someone that crave stability, that you love stability. You probably also have a very strong earth sign in your birth chart, Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus. Doesn't have to be that way. This is general reading, take what resonates. But based on your looks, you're someone that is down to earth, and you are so someone that is so stable and love good foundation. Okay, you're someone that truly have this stability and ability to save money. So based on your looks, you're someone that is not you're not wasting money around. Okay. Based on your look, what assumption do men make about you? The Hierophant. You're someone that is so smart, okay? You look very smart, book smart. Maybe some of you love reading a book or love studying, but you have this smart and knowledge. You are knowledgeable. You look very knowledgeable. You look very... having this strong structure, okay? Having this good tradition that you still keep. You love tradition, okay? It's either your religion, your spirituality, or your culture related to your ancestor. You keep the culture, even though you're not practicing your culture anymore, but you still respect your ancestor. You still respect your parents. You respect your culture. You respect your tradition. You respect your spiritual group or religion, okay? And you're also, based on your looks, you are someone that truly respect tradition, okay? You're so traditional. You're someone that love custom, tradition, okay? It doesn't matter where you live right now. You probably go abroad or move out of state or out of country, but or out of you know, where you born, but that's okay. You still keep that tradition inside of you, okay? You bring that tradition wherever you go. You're someone that is so culture, rich in culture, okay? You're someone that based on your looks, maybe you wear your traditional clothes sometime, or you have traditional like custom holiday that you still celebrate, or you love cooking your traditional cuisine, traditional foods, snack, dinner, or holiday. You still celebrate your traditional holiday, or your spiritual or your religion holiday, okay? You still have this strong contact with your family. You're a family person in the sense that you truly respect where you come from. You truly respect your ancestor, your parents. You know, it doesn't matter what kind of relationship that you have right now. This is a message, intuitive message for some of you, but you still respect that tradition, okay, guys? That's based on your looks. That's what men assume about you, okay? And then the Two of Cups. So you're someone that very agreeable, very cooperative based on your looks. You're someone that has this peaceful nature about you, okay? You probably dress like a hippie, or you love unique things, or you're my LGBTQ community for some of you. But you also probably doesn't have to be that way. But you, some of you, regardless of who you are, you love this tolerant culture. You love this peaceful nature. You have this peaceful nature inside of you that truly, men truly can see that, okay? Men truly assume that based on your looks. Like, you just dress up very unique. You're this is my group that are very unique in their style, you know. You have that colorful things about you. You're so unique. You're such a unicorn. You're so creative, highly creative group. Okay, group number two, you're such so highly creative. So men assume that you're someone that is so creative based on your look. You have this harmony, this peaceful, this balance about you that you somehow, for some reason, men feels comfortable around you, and they assume that you're someone that already know a lot of culture, that you surround yourself with a lot of culture, a lot of people that different than you, that makes you this so tolerant, this so harmony, someone that truly an ideal partner, okay? They assume that you're such an ideal partner, an ideal family member, okay? They assume that you will be a good partner for them, okay? If they have such a romantic interest or crush on you, then they assume that you are someone that will be the future partner, that is, you know, that they would love to have you in their life, okay? Group number two, that's the assumption that men make about you based on your looks. Okay, what else, right? We're gonna find out some more here, okay? You have shape shifter, okay? So this is like my magician group. You have this colorful things about you. Based on your looks, men assume that you are probably a tarot reader or a magician, or you understand the law of attraction, or you truly can transform your life. You have this glow up moment that men truly see from your looks, okay? You have this skill at navigating through different levels of consciousness, ability to see the potential in everything. So based on your looks, men assume that you're someone that has a lot of potential, a lot of skills, a lot of talent, okay? You're so talented based on your looks, okay? What else? I see it here. Based on your looks, what assumption do men make about you? Child nature. Friendships with animals, communication with nature spirit. So you have this childlike nature about you. You're so joyful. You're so funny, bubbly, okay? Like a kid at heart. And you're so friendly. So based on your looks, men assume that you're such a friendly person. Men assume that you're someone that's so open-minded to the new concept, open-minded to new friendship. You open your heart to new friendship. It's either with your pet, with animals, or with a man in general, okay? This is my group that also has significant relationship with men, either platonic or romantic, okay? So many men has romantic interest in you because they find you as a comfort company, as a comfort human being that they can just be friends with, that they don't have to pretend, okay? Because you are this child nature. You have this quality of friendship, giving that friendship based on your looks, okay? Men feels comfortable. Men assume that you will be a great friend. Men assume that you not only just will be a great friend, you also will be a great partner if they have a crush or romantic interest in you. But if they have platonic interest in you, then men truly assume that you're someone that is so friendly, you're open-minded based on your looks because you're just so unique, okay? Comment below if you truly picking group number two and this resonate with you. You're such a unique person, okay? Or you probably got called that you're such a unique, you have unique style about you, okay? It's just so rare. That is someone that is this dreamy, intuitive, mysterious, but also at the same time colorful and very expressive and creative at the same time, okay? What else? Based on your look, what assumptions do men make about you? Priest. So you have this leadership about you. You are very spiritual, okay? You have very strong spiritual ties with your religion or your spirituality. But also there's a leadership inside of you that men assume you're someone that can lead the group of people, that you can lead the movement, that you can lead your spiritual group or religion group, that you're just this leader in spirituality, okay? Especially in spirituality, when the priest card appeared here, facilitate spiritual commitment, serve as a channel of spiritual energy. So you can channeling. Men assume that you can channel. You are an empath. So men assume that you are an empath here. Okay, maybe you are an empath for real. Okay, comment below group number two if this is resonate with you. But that's based on your look. Men assume that you are an empath person, and someone that has leadership quality or has authority or leadership position, and someone that is so mysterious. But also at the same time, you have this great intuition with the moon card, and you're so sensitive and an empath with the moon card also, okay? And with the Hierophant, you're someone that has this tradition, structure, okay? But at the same time too, you're just this unique magical unicorn, very unique, okay? Very artistic. What else? What assumptions do men make about you based on your look? For my viewers who pick group number two. Based on your looks, what assumptions do men make about you? Group number two. Based on your look, what assumption do men make about you? For my viewers who pick group number two. You know, if you want to grab coffee, tea, snack, or your drinks, go ahead. We're still gonna have fun here together. I'm gonna shuffle this card in front of you, all right? What assumptions do men make about you based on your looks? For my viewers who pick group number two. Thank you. You have justice. Yeah, you're really good with gold jewelry too, okay? You look very expensive, but you also look very wise and wisdom. You literally probably work in legal field. Doesn't have to be that way, but just it's just specific message for some of you. But in general, men assume that you are someone that truly brave. You have this courage to fight for justice, to fight for your dreams, to get justice, okay? Men assume that you are someone that is so it's hard to beat you. Basically, you are very strong in your determination when you want to reach the goal. So men assume that you're someone that truly determined, okay, persistent. Okay, that's what I see it here, okay? It is very interesting because the priest and the Hierophant coming together with justice and the moon. The Hierophant, the Moon, and Justice is major arcana, okay? There is this just strong character about you, very strong, intense, vibes that men assume about you based on your looks. Okay, maybe you dress also very nice here with gold, yellow, bright colors is really good on you, colorful, but especially gold jewelry that will be very look good on you based in here. Okay, this is what just men assumption. Okay, what assumptions do men make about you based on your looks? Very interesting here. Okay, you have Six of Pentacles, yeah, and you have the Hermit, yeah. Let me see it here. Now, the Hermit card appear here, guys. Hear me out. Men assume that you are someone that introvert. But if you're not introvert, then you are in between, ambivert, between introvert and extrovert. You also need alone time. So based on your looks, based on your smile, based on your gazing, okay, based on your whole looks, men assume that you need your alone time too, okay? That you're not afraid to be alone, that you're not afraid to detach yourself, okay, from the group, from community, from drama, okay, detach yourself. So you're not afraid to be alone, you're not afraid to sit alone, you're not afraid to eat alone, okay? Basically, you're not afraid to be alone, but you're not lonely. That's different, okay? Because we see this with the Six of Pentacles, you're someone that is so generous, but also this is confirmation, this is a Japanese woman here, this is confirmation that you are rich in culture and tradition too. Okay, this is Japanese woman wearing their traditional hairdo, and we see that they drinking tea. This is, you have this generosity, generous based on your look. Men assume that you're someone that is so generous. Men assume also this is a confirmation that you're someone that truly generous, rich in culture, okay, generous in sharing what you have. But at the same time, if you have to be alone as a consequence of whatever it is that happened in your life, you trust that as your journey of the Hierophant. You trust that as something, your knowledge, this is a knowledge about you, okay? Men assume that you are knowledgeable, you're smart, based on your looks, and you realize that in life you need to share abundance that you have. With the Six of Pentacles, based on your look, you are such a generous person. And then with the Hermit card and the Justice, you believe that even though you're alone, but the energy that you give to the universe will be strong enough to attract good people and good things into your life and bring justice to you. Okay, so that's what I see it here. Very interesting, because this is not usual, this is unusual. And this is just assumption that men makes about you, that men make about you based on your looks, okay? But truly, the Justice card truly appear here, meaning that you just have this air of confident, air of wisdom, air of justice, okay? You treat people very kind. You respect other people's rights. You never step on other people's toes. You try not to step on other people's toes here, okay? And you just mind your own business with the Hierophant and the Hermit. And it's not a problem at all for you, okay? So that's based on your looks. Men truly assume that you're someone that truly enjoy your alone time. You also probably water sign, okay, with the moon. You have a Cancer. Predominantly Cancer, probably your south node maybe in Cancer, or your moon sign in Cancer, or your Venus in Cancer, or your sun sign in Cancer, okay? Sun, moon, rising probably, doesn't have to be that way. Take what resonates, this is general reading, but that's what I see it here, okay? Now with the Two of Cups here coming before the Hermit, showing me that based on your look, men assume that you're not nagging, because you can be a good partner, but you're not afraid also to be alone. So you're independent. This is an independent group, independent woman, independent man. Miss Independent, you know that song? Yeah, so that's what I see it here, okay? And you have rare ability to shapeshifter just based on your looks. You look very magical here, okay? Comment below if this resonates with you, my dear beautiful group number two. That's your reading for today. You are welcome to watch another pile because there must be another message for you there. Other than that, you're also welcome to watch my other pick a card video readings on my time playlist because I have so many timeless pick a card video readings that you will absolutely love it. Please comment on this video, like this video, and also share. Don't forget to click the bell button so you will not miss any future readings from me. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please consider subscribe because that will make me easier to get your energy for the next reading. And in return, you help my channel to grow. I'm so thankful, guys, for everyone that always helps supporting my channel. All right, guys. Other than that, thank you so much. And I see you on my next video. Thank you. And bye-bye! Hello, my dear group number three. If you're picking picture number three, then this is your reading. My reading is timeless. You are meant to see it right now. Before I begin, I will be very grateful if you're willing to subscribe to my channel. And also, please click the bell button so you will not miss any future readings from me. And I'm so thankful, guys, for everyone that always support my channel. Please also comment below, like this video, and share this video. All right, guys, go ahead, grab your coffee, tea, snack, or drink, and we're gonna having fun together today and find out what assumption do men make about you based on your looks. All right, please show me for my viewers who pick group number three. What assumption do men make about you based on your look? What assumptions do men make about you based on your look? What assumptions do men make about you based on your look? What assumptions do men make about you based on your look? Pile number three, group number three. What assumptions do men make about you based on your look? What assumptions do men make about you based on your look? What assumptions do men make about you based on your look? Thank you. All right, guys. Now, group number three. What assumptions do men make about you based on your looks? You have the Page of Pentacles. Yep. You have the Nine of Pentacles. Wow. You have the Fool. Okay. You have the Nine of Swords. Okay. Okay. Right off the bat, I see that you are very charming and magnetic, okay? Men assume that you're such a charming person based on your looks. You're like dreamy and magnetic, like a siren, like a mermaid, you know, the mermaid vibes. You're like magnetic, very gorgeous, and very unique, okay? How is that mermaid vibes that attract opposite sex to you, okay, sexually? I also see here that man is willing to take risks near you. You are someone that giving them the fool vibes, willing to take risk, okay? Innocent. You're innocent like a mermaid, but then there is just this very magnetic things about you based on your look, okay? You look like someone that is so innocent. You are so desirable, Okay, you look very desirable, highly desirable. This is like high caliber of mermaid. You look very, very beautifully magnetic. Okay. There is this sense of risk with you. It's almost like your beauty invite men to take risks. To maybe they already in a relationship or you already in a relationship, but they still want to get close to you. Okay, it's just specific message for some of you. This is general reading. Take what resonate. Okay, I see here that you have a very strong earth sign in your birth chart. Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo, with the appearance of Pentacles. Doesn't have to be that way, but it is possible for some of you. You also have an air sign. Aquarius, Gemini, Libra. Doesn't have to be that way, but it's just for some of you, okay? And I see here that despite your magnetism, despite that, your looks giving man, you are someone that is so talented. You're so artistic, okay? You're so artistic. You are creative. Maybe you also love going to the museum, art museum. Okay, but you also love painting, singing, dancing. You have a lot of talent and also skillful. Okay, you're talented. So men assume that you're such a talented person. You're such an artistic person. You're someone that has a lot of skills and doesn't have to be limited with an art world. Okay, you can be also very talented in cooking, very talented in, photography, traveling, speaking. Musical instrument, building something. Okay. In here, I also see that you are someone that get a lot of attention with the Nine of Swords. That people, you're someone that is appears so unique, that's so unforgettable. Okay, that's what men assume about you based on your looks. You also look very prosperous, very abundant. You probably wear a lot of branded, or you love branded stuff. Doesn't have to be that way. It's just for some of you. But with the Nine of Pentacles, it's the card of success, prosperity, abundance. So you have this look, successful looks. Maybe you dress in the business casual or business clothes, and you look really good when you wear business casual or business formal business looks. You also someone that, based on your looks, you are someone that truly accomplished. Okay, men assume that you having this accomplishment in your life. Okay, that you have a very comfortable life. You enjoy your life. You enjoy your life to the fullest. You love traveling. You love making good money. You are a hardworking person. And so then you love enjoying also the hard work that you have in your life, the fruits of your hard work. Okay. Now, with the Fool here, men assume that you are younger than your actual age, okay? Or they mistakenly for your age because you appear very innocent, appear younger than your actual age, or you just have these youthful vibes. You really care about your skin regimen, or you clean up really well. You care about healthy body, healthy food, feet. You go to the gym often, or you just clean up really well. You clearly care about hygiene here with the Fool, okay? So you appear very, very polished, very clean, and that's based on your looks. That's what men assume about you, okay? This is general reading, guys. I also see here that men assume that you love fashion and you love beauty based on the makeup. And the hair, we can tell that you probably have a pink or red hair, black or blonde or brunette. Okay. That's for some of you. And some of you really, truly love braids. Okay. You braided your hair like this, your hairstyle straight, wavy, or shortcut like this, or you braid your hair. Okay. There is this sense of earthly goddess about you, but also you probably have water sign, Cancer, Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpio. This is my group that is look like a mermaid. You know that kind of mermaid beauty? It's so magnetic, charming, alluring, okay? You're so alluring. That's what I'm trying to say here. Based on your looks, you look very sexy and alluring, guys, okay? What else? What else? We're gonna find out group number three. What assumptions do men make about you based on your looks? You have damsel. Oh! No coincidence, I just shuffled this card in front of you guys. Damsel, understanding the nature of healthy romance inspire you to rely on yourself. Yeah, like risk. Men willing to take risks for your love, for your attention. So you're just like having these vibes of mermaid, of damsel. You know, of someone that need to be rescued, of a romantic person. Men assume based on your look that you're such a romantic person. Maybe your dress or your clothes or your clothing style or the choices of the color that you pick for your makeup or for your clothes. Okay, you look very romantic, you dress very romantic, your style is romantic, and your personality also romantic. Okay, that's like coming out of your looks. Okay, you probably love romantic novel or romantic movie, TV show, especially something about the prehistoric or historical drama, like Bridgerton or Jane Austen, movies, okay, book, novels. But you reduce this romantic vibes, and mermaid is romantic too, guys. All right. What else? You have liberator, freeing yourself and others from outmoded beliefs, releasing negative thought patterns. Yeah, so based on your look, you're someone that free, you free to dress whatever that please your heart. So this is my group that when they put their makeup on, when they put their dress on, or if you're a man, when you put your clothes or suit or shoes, you choose to please yourself first, okay? You love yourself to the point that you just want to dress up for yourself, not for getting other people attention, but you cannot help, but you get a lot of this, a lot of attention come to you, okay? That's what else? You have a guide. What assumptions do men make about you based on your looks? Represent the nature of the divine in life and in yourself. Yeah, there is just this divinely vibes in your looks, okay? You probably also spiritual. You probably wear crystals or diamond. You just appear very divine, okay? Very beautiful, but divinely beautiful, okay? That's what the assumption that men make about you based on your looks. Now we're going to find out more, guys, of course, all right? What assumption do men make about you based on your look? What assumptions do men make about you based on your look? What assumptions do men make about you based on your look? Okay. Thank you. You have the Hierophant. Okay, you have Ten of Swords. Wow, this is a very strong, attractive person here. And you have the Star. Gorgeous. Now, guys, some of you truly look like you have this knowledge, like you gain knowledge, okay? You look very smart. Based on your look, men assume that you're such a smart person. You have a knowledge that you accumulated in your life from your life experiences. Men assume that you're someone that has a lot of experiences in love relationship, okay? This is general reading. Take what resonates. This is what I see here. You also look like someone that come from a very good background, of education, or you are now in the pursuit of education, or you're still in school. So based on your looks, men assume that you're still in school, or you are still learning about something, or you are climbing to the ladder of success or management in the office. But this is someone that love gaining knowledge, okay? So that's the assumption that men make about you based on your look. But also, you're someone that, you know, you're never satisfied with the knowledge that you have. You have this thirst of knowledge, thirst of new information. You love researching and educating yourself, not just from school or university, but you also educated yourself from books or internet or browsing the internet or newspaper. But this is someone that generally they just love studying. They love studying about life. They love studying about their fields, their goals. They love studying about new hobby and trying to acquire a new hobby. Or you also love studying about new foreign language. And men assume that you're someone that rich in knowledge, rich in diversity of knowledge, rich in culture, and you're someone that truly relies about your skill and talent and your contribution to the organization. So if this man is in the same workplace or school with you, they assume that you're someone that truly relies your worth. Okay, you get what I'm saying? What I mean here is you truly know you put a lot of effort, okay, with this Nine of Pentacles, your hard work, guide and liberator, and you realize you bring a lot to the table, to the organization, to the group, to the relationship, to the family. And so then you are so confident, but you're not cocky. You're confident in your skill and you're confident in your knowledge, and you truly someone that is so elegant and business minded. Okay, this is lady boss, man boss vibes, but more so to the point that you just want to keep learning. So that's what men assume about you based on your looks. Now with the Ten of Swords, this is a confirmation again for the Nine of Swords that you truly ran free in some people's mind, that based on your looks, the assumption that men make about you is you always left mark wherever you go, that it is hard to forget about you because you're just so unique, so romantic and beautiful, and you have these unique abilities and skills and qualities about you that truly, even though it is platonic relationship, but men assume that you are someone that truly can capture their heart, that truly stay in their mind for a period of time or longer time, that it is hard to move on from you because you're just this mermaid, beautiful mermaid, okay? And just you have this vibes about you, and the looks that you have is truly unforgettable. This is my group that truly unforgettable is the emphasized, because there's just this alluring also energy and looks about you, okay, that I read from this whole cards here. Now with the Star card, this is no surprise that it comes of Indian for this reading, meaning that based on your looks, you look like a star, you look like an influencer, you dress very fashionable, you are trendy, you are trendsetter, you have this star quality, celebrity quality, star vibes, okay? Wherever you go, it seems like you just shine bright like a star there, and all attention goes to you, okay? It's hard to ignore you because you're just this star. You're beautiful. You have this bright shine with your talent, skills, and the way that you put your makeup, the way that you put yourself together with your clothes, fashion style, the way you speak, the way you interact with others. You have such a class of a star. You know, it is so rare that someone truly can appear with the whole package. You have the beauty, brain, and behavior. You have this beauty and behavior like a star. Okay, some people probably love watching your Instagram story without liking your picture, but guys, they are one of your fans. They love keeping up with you. They want to know your life. They want to know the progress of your life. They want to know what clothes that you wear today or what activities that you do today. But guys, you truly have this star vibe, star quality, like a mermaid that also has this star quality, you know? I truly see it here because she truly fly with her wings and she has this one of star. You truly like magical person here because these looks that you have. Maybe you also being called the star of the room sometime, or you won, some of you won like homecoming queen, prom queen, prom king, homecoming king. You dress very trendy. People always ask where do you buy your clothes, or you put makeup very beautifully. You just appear very, very beautiful here, very gorgeous, okay? The mermaid vibes, kind of like magnetic, charming, and beautiful. You have that star quality, but you also smart here. It's truly appear with the Hierophant card, the guide, the Fool, and Nine of Pentacles, okay? The Damsel, this is very romantic, romantic group, okay, guys? All right, guys, that's your reading for today. You are welcome to watch another pile because there must be another message for you there. Other than that, you're also welcome to watch my other pick a card videos reading because I have so many timeless pick a card videos that you will absolutely love it. Please consider to subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed. That will make me easier to get your energy for the next reading. And in return, you help my channel to grow. Please also don't forget to click the bell button so you will not miss any future readings from me. Thank you so much, guys, for all of your support. Please comment below whether it's resonate with you. Please also like this video and share. And other than that, thank you so much and I'll see you on my next video. Thank you and bye-bye.